All right, so in Pong 1, we took a look at how to emulate like we were coding for something like the NES or the Atari. We ended up using the push library to write to a virtual raster, and then we stretched that to fit our actual window of 1280 by 720. So things are not very visually interesting yet, and this update actually aspires to sort of, you know, take us in that direction. So we're gonna get involved with drawing rectangles on the screen. As you can see on the left and the right side, we have the paddles that are gonna get drawn. Eventually, we're gonna manipulate those paddles, but for this example, they are static, so they can't actually move. But this just sort of helps us illustrate what we're moving towards. You'll notice that there's a ball in the center as well. And at the top, we have the Hello Pong text. And you'll notice that this is actually written in a different font. So this is a smaller 8-pixel font. And I'm going to show you a website where you can actually grab any font file you want to use in your application. And I'm going to show you with a couple of functions in the next slide how we get a font actually imported into our code. So here are the important functions for this section. So for the first off, love.graphics.newFont takes in a path and a size for the font. And this expects a file to exist somewhere in your project, a .ttf or .otf. And we'll show you from defont.com how you can actually download a font like that. And we'll use one in our example. But this creates a font object. And then the next function, love.graphics.setFont, actually tells Love that, okay, now from this point onwards, we're gonna be drawing with this font. And it sort of flips a switch almost, just like the push library ended up doing in a state machine sort of way. Love.graphics.setFont operates in a very similar fashion. And then we'll get into love.graphics.clear, which takes an RGBA series of values. And this might be something that you've looked at already in the course, where pixels are represented often by 24 bits of color, sometimes by 32 bits of color. In this case, it's the exact same way, but Love treats, especially with the newer versions, each component as being from 0 to 1, floating point value. Now, it's a little bit trickier to sort of think in that way, so I'll show you how you can map 0 to 255, which you might have seen thus far in the course, to that 0 to 1 value pretty easily. Lastly, we'll look at love.graphics.rectangle, which takes in a mode, so whether we want it to be a line rectangle or a filled rectangle. It takes in an X and a Y, so where we want to actually place it in our coordinate system, and then a width and a height, so we can define its dimensions. So let's actually transition. First thing I want to take a look at is defont.com. So if you go to defont.com, and in particular, I ended up going to this bitmap, pixel bitmap section. Now the font that we're going to end up using is here on this page. It's called 04B03. And if you go over to this download link here, you can actually get a zip file for it. I ended up already pre-downloading it to the sample code. So we're just going to use it there. So I'm going to go here into my JHarvard dev games Pong, and I'm just going to create Pong 2. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here to the previous bit of code, Pong 1. I'm going to copy that, and I'm just going to bring this over here to games Pong, and I'm going to delete Pong 2 because I want to start us off from the Pong 1 sort of finished code that we had in the last section. So I'm going to rename this to Pong 2. And I'm going to go back over to games final, where I actually have all the distro here. I'm going to go into Pong 2. I'm going to grab this font.ttf. You'll notice that it is, you can see a little preview here on Mac. It is the same font as 04B03. I'm going to come back here to my games Pong 2. I'm just going to paste it right in there. So it's literally just like the push library. It's a .ttf or .otf, depending on the font. And it's just placed right inside of the project directory. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to open this in VS Code. So I'm just going to drag it over here. And just like always, I'm going to expand this completely. And I'm going to go open up my main.lua. So this is the distro of the push library, sort of one that we did in the last section. But you'll notice that there are some comments here that we didn't apply in the last one because we were live coding it. So I'm going to do a few things here. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to use that love.graphics.newFont function that we talked about. So I'm going to say small font is equal to love.graphics.newFont, and it's font.ttf, and I want this to be an 8-pixel font. And then if we want to actually use this to draw anything, to write anything with our print or printf function, I need to say love.graphics.setFont of small font. Because remember, this new font function actually creates a font object, and we need to set that font object in order to use it going forward. So that's what this does here. If I save this and then I run it, you'll notice that it does indeed work. Now in the middle of the screen, we have it saying Hello Pong, and it's nice and crisp and smaller, so it looks a little bit more like we should expect. So I'm going to go back over to VS Code. I'm going to change this print call, as you saw in the in the screenshot, the little sample screenshot, it was a little bit higher up. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to say draw it 20 pixels down instead. So if I do that, now we have Hello Pong being written up at the very top of the screen. Now, I don't really like the fact that the background is purely black. So if we end up going back to our slides here, you'll notice that the background of Hello Pong is a different color. And in order to get around that, we're actually going to use a different color or a different function, which I actually have here on the first slide, love.graphics.clear, which takes in an RGB and a value. So very easily, if you want that to happen, if you want the background to clear like that, to draw in that color, you could also think of it like love.graphics.fill, but it's love.graphics.clear. You need to do it before you draw anything else, because otherwise it's going to completely draw over everything else in the scene. So what I'm going to do is after the push apply, I'm going to say love.graphics.clear, and then it takes in those four values, R, G, B, and A. And I have it written down here because I don't remember off the top of my head what they are. It is 40, 45, 40, 45, 52, and 255. Now I'm thinking in terms of 256 here, 0 to 255. But love, again, with the newer versions, it doesn't actually treat this appropriately. If I end up running this, it's white because one is pure white. So it's actually not working the way that we would expect. Because we're not actually using 0 to 255, we're using 0 to 1. So we need to map these values to 0 to 1. And to do that, it's as simple as saying 40 divided by 255, 45 divided by 255, 52 divided by 255, and 255 divided by 255. And if I run that, you do indeed see that we have Hello Pong written on the screen, and we're clearing the screen with that sort of grayish color. So that has aligned successfully. Now we have the Hello Pong word written, we have the background cleared the right way. Now we need to actually draw the rectangles. So to do that, I'm just going to do a few calls here. I'm going to say love.graphics.rectangle. And let's start maybe with the ball. So I'll say I want this to be in fill mode. I want this to be roughly at in the middle of the screen, exactly. So I'll say virtual width, virtual height, or divided by two rather. So virtual width divided by two, virtual height divided by two. I want the ball maybe to be, let's say maybe 5 pixels large. So width 5 and height of 5. Let's go ahead, save, draw. And there we go. We see that we have the ball roughly in the middle of the screen. Now, the thing with that is that we're actually not drawing it right in the middle of the screen. So if you recall, everything is based upon its top left corner. So we're actually going right into the middle of the screen. I'll run this again just for illustration. We're going right in the middle of the screen, and this point is the middle. So we're actually drawing the ball right at the middle, but it's sort of shifted down into the right a little bit. So that's not exactly what we want. So what I want to do instead is say, and because we've chosen 5, it's actually, we can't really divide evenly, but I'll say virtual width divided by 2 minus 2, and virtual height divided by 2 minus 2, which will shift it by roughly half the size of the ball upwards to the left. And you'll see that it more or less is now directly in the center. And if we chose a value like, let's say, 6 and 6, and made this minus 3, minus 3, then it would be perfectly aligned in the center of the screen. Now we have the ball drawn, so why don't we go ahead now and draw the paddles. So I'll say love.graphics.rectangle. And I'm just going to choose some arbitrary values here. So I'll say, again, these need to be filled rectangles, not line rectangles. I'll draw this one as a line just for illustration. And I want this to be maybe 5 pixels from the left. Let's say 20 pixels from the top of the screen. I want this to be 5 pixels wide by 20 pixels tall. And then I'll do this here. I'll say love.graphics.rectangle of line. And let's say that this is going to be virtual width minus 10. So it's going to be towards the right side, but shifted 10 over, which gives us 5 pixels of space. And then it accounts for the 5 pixels of the width of the paddle. I'll say virtual height minus, let's say, 40. So it's going to be towards the bottom, but it's going to be shifted up by 20 and then 20 to account for the size of the paddle. And then again, 5 and 20 for the dimensions of the paddle. If I run this, you do indeed see that I have two paddles on the left and the right, and they are being drawn as line rectangles. Now, this is kind of a cool aesthetic, admittedly, but just to keep things consistent with what we've shown so far, I'm going to transition these back to being fill rectangles like so. I'm going to save it, run it, and now we do indeed see that we have something very similar to what we saw in the slides previously. So let's go back over to the slide deck here. And that was it for the rectangle update. So everything looks a lot more visually interesting now. We've gotten into rectangles and colors and importing fonts. In the next update, we're going to actually start working on the fact that currently our rectangles are completely static. They're just there being drawn to the screen. We're going to actually get into moving them with Pong 3.